Roadblocks, barricades and intimidation did not stop the tens of thousands of Malaysians gathering together in the heart of the city of Kuala Lumpur on 19th November 2016. This is the fifth birthday march since its inception in 2007 to demand for electorate reforms in the country. Several key leaders of the Berish movement were arrested on the eve of this march. Their arrests did not deter the tens of thousands of multi-ethnic Malaysians coming from near and far into the city that day. These courageous Malaysians were not afraid of the threat of tear gas, water cannon, or facing arrests by the authorities. They were determined to exercise their right for peaceful assembly, freedom of speech and expression, but more urgently, to show anger and resistance to a corrupt and oppressive government.
MP for Kalimantan Utara. We are here today to fight for the rights of the people. We are here today for free and fair elections. We are here today to save this country from the corrupt, and only the people through a free and fair elections are able to remove this corrupt government. So, Berish, everyone.
From Penang. I'm here for five demands. Pilihan raya yang bersih, kerajaan yang bersih, kukuhkan demokrasi berparlimen, berparlimen hak membantah dan juga memperkasakan Sabah dan Sarawak.
My name is Laika and I'm from Penang and I'm a disabled person as you can see and came all the way here to Berish for clean and fair elections because it affects all of us, the disabled, Malaysians, everyone.
Malaysia is being governed by clowns and crooks, so I'm here with other fellow citizens to protest against our corrupt Prime Minister and his government.
I'm here at Berish 5 in 2016, and I'm here because we need to have a change in our country, and I'm here because I mean, you all need to stand up and be counted, literally, stand up and be counted.
My name is Syam Sundar. I think Berish is the beginning of a united, harmonious Malaysia. We should do Berish every year.
Berish did not end that day. Rather, it is a movement that is gaining momentum and strength. Malaysians from all walks of life are standing up to continue to oppose bigotry, racism and fraud in the country. The road ahead will be a struggle like we have never struggled before since our country's independence. We have to reclaim our vision enshrined in our constitution, where the nation will flourish, where there will be equal and fair opportunities for all its citizens, served by a just and clean government. For this, we will continue to gather and march, even if it takes many more years.